Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. During meetings and public events at the International Astronautical Congress October 12th through 16th in Jerusalem, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden and several other NASA officials highlighted the agency's recently released plan to send astronauts to Mars in the 2030s. They also emphasized the need for international partnerships and cooperation to make a mission of this magnitude a reality, the importance of harnessing enthusiasm for space exploration, and the need to encourage young people to develop the skills we'll need for the journey to Mars. October 16th was a record-breaking day in space for International Space Station Commander Scott Kelly. It gave him 383 total days in space, the most cumulative days in space by a U.S. astronaut, a record previously held by NASA's Mike Fink. Kelly will break another record on October 29th, his 216th consecutive day in space, surpassing Michael Lopez Alegria's record for the single longest space flight by an American. Kelly's time in space as part of a one-year mission helps us better understand the physical and mental effects of long-duration spaceflight, which is critical to NASA's journey to Mars. During an October 14th flyby, NASA's Cassini spacecraft passed within 1,142 miles of Saturn's moon Enceladus to capture the first close-up look at the plumes of icy spray situated in the moon's north polar region. This is a prelude to an even closer flyby on October 28th, when Cassini will get within 30 miles of the moon's southern polar region for the most accurate measurements yet of the plume's composition. December 3rd is the targeted launch date for the fourth commercial resupply services mission of Orbital ATK's Cygnus spacecraft to the International Space Station. This will be the first flight of the company's enhanced Cygnus Advanced Maneuvering spacecraft, which can deliver more than 7,700 pounds of cargo. The supply spacecraft is scheduled to lift off aboard a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, Florida, at about 6 p.m. Eastern Time. NASA has awarded new venture-class launch services contracts to three companies: Firefly Space Systems Incorporated of Cedar Park, Texas, Rocket Lab USA Incorporated of Los Angeles, and Virgin Galactic LLC of Long Beach, California. The launch vehicles developed by these companies will be used to provide access to low Earth orbit for small satellites, which currently only make it to space as secondary payloads on other missions. Small satellites, including CubeSats, are playing an increasingly larger role in exploration, technology demonstration, scientific research, and educational investigations at NASA. Soaring temperatures and heavy traffic did not deter some 45,000 people from attending the recent two-day open house event at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. JPL manages several NASA missions that have captured the public's attention recently. These include the Mars Science Laboratory's Curiosity rover, Dawn, the first spacecraft to visit a dwarf planet, Ceres, and the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, which has found key evidence that water does exist on present-day Mars. NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden helped kick off the 2015 Combined Federal Campaign recently at headquarters. Each year, donations from NASA employees make a positive impact on the lives of others who are less fortunate. There is a wide choice of approved local, national, and international charities to which employees around the agency can donate. The campaign ends December 15th. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.